Hi, everybody. And now what I want to do is I want to talk about a scenario that might have no correlation. And no correlation essentially means that when you have a couple of variables, they don't produce a scatter plot that has any direction. So what I did was I tried to come up with a situation that probably wouldn't have any knowable relationship. So imagine that I had 100 people and they were all taking, let's say, a math test, and I also measured their height. And so I put their height on the x-axis, and you know, the scale might go from zero, let's just move this over here, from zero to, let's just say, 200 centimeters. So I'll put this in a different font. Okay. And then their test mark would go from like zero to 100, right? So like when we go around to each person and we ask them, you know, what's your height, or we measure their height, and then we also see how they did on the test, there's no reason to believe that we would see a scatter plot like this, right? There's no reason to believe that. Because what that would suggest for some reason is that if you're taller, you would have a better chance of doing well on the test. And there's no reason to think that would be true, right? So it could potentially happen, but chances are that it's not going to happen. On the other hand, it probably would not be likely to see something like this, right? A negative correlation. So the first one I drew was a positive correlation. The second one I'm drawing here is a negative correlation. Do you think this would be reasonable? Think about what this means. This means that if you're taller, you're going to get a poorer mark on the test. And let's just say once again that this is a math test. This is not like a slam dunking competition or something, right? It's not like the test doesn't have anything to do with your height. So if this was the scenario, then it wouldn't really be realistic, would it? I mean, there had to be some very strange situation that would mean that if you're taller, you get a better mark. So this is probably unrealistic as well. Now, once again, it's not our place to say what could and couldn't happen. So it could happen, and we're not allowed to make the data up, right? Like we can't decide what's gonna happen. We do an experiment and we see what happens. But I would say that the trend of that is very unlikely. That's very unlikely, right? So what could we expect? Well, since test mark is not really in any way related to height, it's probably more realistic that we would see something like this. And this, you see, is an example of no correlation. No correlation is a situation where you can't really tell if there's any kind of trend. You could say, somebody could say that, but then another person could equally look at it and say, no, I see that, right? In general, what you see is just a big old circle. So that's the thing. You know, when you see a relationship between two variables that produces like an oval pattern, like this or like this, that usually means that there's correlation, positive or negative. But if you see a trend of data that produces more like a circle, that means that there's no relationship really between the two variables. So what we can say is, we can say when there is no pattern or trend in between the variables, then we have a situation. Then we have a situation where there is no correlation. Okay, and then, you know, like another thing is that, yeah, I'll make that a little smaller so you can move that over. That's too small now. I know that, Dorian. Move that here. And then we'll move this and make it bigger. So Okay. Another thing that we can say is that if you can draw a circle instead of an oval, around your data points, then it probably means that it is close to being no correlation. Now, so like we're gonna, tomorrow what we'll do is we'll talk about the actual strength of correlation, which is a whole different topic, but I'll just put this over here so you can see it. And so like, this is our main conclusions that we want to draw out of this stuff, okay? So I hope you found that helpful. And remember, there's three scenarios: positive correlation, negative correlation, and no correlation. Let me give you one more thing to think about. What if you had a graph that did this? We'll do once again, test mark and height. What if you had a scenario that was like this? Would that be correlation or not? Well, that's a special scenario, and that under that situation, there is no correlation too. Because what that says is it doesn't matter how high you are or how tall you are, you're always going to have the same test mark. And so that's a special scenario of no correlation. And another special scenario of no correlation would be a situation like this, where you just had a straight line of dots going up. Because that, under that scenario, all it means is no matter what, it says basically everybody's the same height and they all get the same test. So it's like a fairly unrealistic situation, but that would also be a no correlation situation. So those are two special scenarios to think about. Anyway, I hope that helped, and try some of the questions that I've assigned and see how you do.